एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। दिस इज लेक्चर 18 ऑफ अ जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी दी एमसीक्यू पार्ट ऑफ कोफिशियंट ऑफ कंप्रेसिबिलिटी, कोफिशियंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम कंप्रेसिबिलिटी, कोफिशियंट ऑफ परमेबिलिटी एंड कंप्रेशन इंडेक्स। इन दी पार्ट वन वी हैव कवर्ड द न्यूमेरिकल पार्ट ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। ओके, सो नाउ वी विल सी दी एमसीक्यू पार्ट। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज यूनिटलेस। ओके, सो यू हैव फोर ऑप्शन एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज यूनिटलेस। फर्स्ट इज गिवन कोफिशियंट ऑफ कंप्रेसिबिलिटी डिनोटेड एज ए वी, कोफिशियंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम कंप्रेसिबिलिटी एम वी, कंप्रेशन इंडेक्स सी सी, कोफिशियंट ऑफ परमेबिलिटी। सो इफ यू हैव कवर दी थ्योरी पार्ट और दी प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल देन यू कैन ईजली फाइंड दी करेक्ट आंसर। ओके, सो द कोफिशियंट ऑफ कंप्रेसिबिलिटी हैज़ अ यूनिट ऑफ मीटर स्क्वायर पर किलो न्यूटन एंड सिमिलरली द कोफिशियंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम कंप्रेसिबिलिटी यूनिट इज मीटर स्क्वायर पर किलो न्यूटन। ओके, योर कंप्रेशन इंडेक्स इज यूनिटलेस, आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन। ओके, सो दिस इज योर करेक्ट ऑप्शन पर सेकेंड। सो द अदर ऑप्शंस हैव यूनिट बट द कंप्रेशन इंडेक्स इज यूनिटलेस, सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन सी, कंप्रेशन इंडेक्स। नाउ वी विल सी द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन। इफ द कोफिशियंट ऑफ वॉल्यूम कंप्रेसिबिलिटी इज डबल एंड कोफिशियंट ऑफ कंसोलिडेशन एंड यूनिट वेट ऑफ वाटर रिमेन सेम देन द कोफिशियंट ऑफ परमेबिलिटी विल बी। ओके, सो दीज टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर फ्रेम। ओके, सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ यू कैन फाइंड द करेक्ट ऑप्शन। So, if the coefficient of compressibility, here the term coefficient of compressibility, coefficient of consolidation and the coefficient of permeability is given. So, you have to know that there is a formula to for relation between the coefficient of permeability, coefficient of consolidation, coefficient of volume compressibility and gamma W. Okay, so this is the equation that we have used in the previous lecture. So, from this equation, it is given that if the coefficient of volume compressibility is doubled, this is volume compressibility, so if it is doubled, okay, so if it is doubled and the coefficient of consolidation and unit weight of water remains same, then the coefficient of permeability will be, okay, so simply the coefficient of permeability value will also get doubled. So option A is your correct option. Okay, double. Now we will move to the third question. The next question is the coefficient of volume compressibility MV is dash proportional to coefficient of compressibility. Okay, I hope you know the answer of this question. Okay, so if you know the formula and relation between the coefficient of volume compressibility MV and coefficient of compressibility AV, you can easily find the correct option. Okay, so your coefficient of volume compressibility MV is directly proportional to your coefficient of compressibility AV. Okay, so option B will be the correct option. Here some note for you. Okay, next question number 4, the unit of coefficient of compressibility is same too. Okay, so I have already explained that the unit of coefficient of compressibility is meter square per kilonewton and the coefficient of volume compressibility is also meter square per kilonewton. This is unitless. Okay, this is unitless and this is meter per second. Okay, so the correct option will be option C. Okay, both are having the unit of meter square per kilonewton, coefficient of compressibility and coefficient of volume compressibility. Now we will see the question number 5. So the question number 5 is, on an arithmetic scale, the slope for NCC soil between the void ratio and effective stress can be approximated as, first straight line, second is convex, third is oval and fourth one is concave. I have already explained the type of slope for the NCC soil and OCC soil for the arithmetic scale and for the semi-log scale. Okay, so you can cover the previous lecture numerical part of this topic, so you can understand the different types of slope for the NCC and OCC soil for the arithmetic scale and for the semi-log scale. So for this question, it is for the arithmetic scale and the soil is NCC, so the correct option will be your option number D. So the slope will be concave. Next question is, the slope of a virgin curve on a semi-log scale is called. So it is not called coefficient of compressibility. This is clear that the slope is not called coefficient of compressibility. Next, you have the option of compression index and coefficient of compressibility. So the slope for the arithmetic scale is called coefficient of compressibility, not for the semi-log scale. So your option B is correct. The slope of virgin curve on a semi-log scale is called the compression index. Okay. The seventh question is relation between the coefficient of consolidation, coefficient of permeability and the coefficient of volume compressibility. Okay. So we have covered this equation. So option C is your correct option. Your coefficient of permeability is equals to coefficient of consolidation multiplied by coefficient of volume compressibility multiplied by gamma W. This is your correct option. Okay. Now, the question number 8, on a semi-log scale for the graph between the void ratio and effective stress, which value remains in log? Okay, so if you have covered the previous lecture, the numerical lecture of this topic, okay, then you can easily find the correct option. So for the semi-log scale, the effective stress will remain in the, okay, log, and the void ratio is simple void ratio. Okay, so option B is the correct option. Question number 9, choose the correct formula to determine the coefficient of compressibility AV. So the formula to find the coefficient of compressibility AV is the options are ratio of change in the void ratio to semi-log of effective stress. Option B is ratio of change in the effective stress to the change in the void ratio. Option C is the ratio of change in the void ratio to change in the effective stress. So your coefficient of compressibility is equals to change in the void ratio upon change in the effective stress. So option C is the correct option. Okay. So these are the important MCQs of this topic. Now we'll see what are the topics of the previous lectures. So these are the topics of the previous lectures. So you can cover all these lectures from the geotechnical engineering playlist, and in the upcoming lecture we will see some more important numerical on the different topic of geotechnical engineering. So if you haven't subscribed the channel, then please do subscribe it so that you will get a notification about the upcoming lecture.